down south to the land of the pines. I'm thumbing my way into North Carolina, staring up the road and pray to God I see headlights. I made it down the coast in 17 hours, picking me a bouquet of dogwood flowers. And I'm hoping for Raleigh, I can see my baby tonight. So rock me, mama, like a wagon wheel. Rock me, mama, any way you feel. Hey, mama, rock me. Rock me, mama, like the wind and the rain. Rock me, mama, like a southbound train. Hey, mama, rock me. I pick a banjo now. Oh, North Country winters keep a getting me down. Lost my money playing poker, so I had to leave town. But I ain't a turning back to living that old life no more. So rock me, mama, like a wagon wheel. Rock me, mama, any way you feel. Hey, mama, rock me.
Our crew was Life is Rough, and we were crew number one. FoA crew number one was Lori Schwartz and Chris Shea as the advisors. Youth consisted of Aria Kothari, Jillian Hannon, Warren Buck, and Sean Pavin. Throughout the week, we saw that Life is Rough for a homeowner, Crystal. She was forced to move out of her house due to a difficult divorce and had to leave her job due to her developing sickness. Even though she had been through these difficult times, she still had a beautiful family consisting of 7 dogs, 6 cats, 4 kids, and her fiancé.
Crystal had so many setbacks in her life, yet she pushed through for her loving family. This is why we were blessed and grateful to have helped her family's life by rebuilding her deck railing and refinishing her bathroom. Crystal always remained positive and had a cheerful attitude. We can take Crystal as an example by realizing that no matter how rough life can be, a positive attitude can overcome life's adversities.
Our crew was right on track, consisting of advisors Larry and Avery, and youths Regan, Mel, Ryan, and Jill. We spent our week installing drywall along a basement staircase. After putting up the drywall, we mudded, sanded, primed, and painted it.
The family we served lived in Telford, Tennessee. Their names were Mama, Becky, Carl, and Jacqueline, along with their 3 dogs, Momo, Chevy, and Junior. We had a wonderful time working together to get the walls up for our family.
The highlight of our week was ending our days with Jacqueline singing Jesus Loves Me to us. Though we had minor frustrating setbacks, we finished the job better than we could have imagined. We're so thankful for the memories, laughs, and the excessive amounts of sun chips and sandwiches that we shared all week. Signing off, Crew 2, best crew.
Crew 3, Pixel Perfect, aka Djibouti Crew, consisted of advisors Katie and Derek and youth Maggie, Hannah, Brendan, Jake, and Carolyn. Our homeowners residing in Jonesboro, Tennessee, consisted of Sherry, the grandma, Travis, the father, and Hannah's 10-year-old daughter. The house was in need of new hallway flooring and painted walls.
After tearing up 10 layers of flooring, the boys started the long process of laying down brand new flooring. Because of Sherry's old and rusty jigsaw, it was miraculously made easier for them. After sanding and spackling the walls for 2 full days, Wednesday brought a new challenge for the girls, demo day. It wasn't easy being told that 2 of the walls would have to come down, but perseverance and the idea of making their home warmer, safer, and drier prevailed. Shout out to Kyle for rewiring the living room electrical during this. Although this week was stressful, our hard work was rewarded with ice cream, Walmart, and of course Bojangles. Our homeowners motivated us in every way possible and made sure we were always welcomed, especially when we would have daily dance parties with Hannah. This week not only left us with an impact on our homeowners, but ourselves individually, and brought us closer together as a family.
Our crew, Cadet Kelly, consisted of advisors Carol and James, and youth Caitlin, Joanna, Claire, and Michael. We worked on 2 homes, the first finishing the spindles on a wheelchair ramp for Tim. We met Tim's 2 dogs. Even though we were only there for 2 days, we got to know Tim well by eating lunch together.
The second homeowner's name was Bobby, and there we worked on the siding of his home. Bobby was a lively person who was always willing to help around the worksite. He was so big on stewardship, he even went out of his own way to buy materials for the project. Being the final group to work on both homes, it was amazing to see the projects finished and bring a peaceful conclusion to the homeowners and ourselves.
Our crew name this year was Luck of the Irish. Our advisors were Nicole and Mike. Our group was Delana, Nolan, Gigi, and Zach. During the week, we worked on Kathy's home. Kathy was the sweetest woman who welcomed us every day. She enjoyed eating lunch with us while sharing her story. Our job had two major parts, roofing and underpinning. While the girls worked on finishing the Hawaiian blue tin roof, the boys worked on putting the rest of the underpinning on the house. We came together on Friday to repair three holes in her kitchen and living room.
Coming into this week, we all had minimal construction experience, and with every day brought on a new challenge, but all week we worked together to complete everything that was asked of us. Every day started with a car ride where we jammed out to our favorite songs. When we got to the site, we were greeted by Cats, Nubbin and Bella, and the white horse, Tim. And most importantly, Miss Kathy made sure to say hi to every one of us. Together, we were able to accomplish more than anyone thought we could. We became part of Kathy's family, and Kathy became part of ours. She was so thankful that we helped make her home warmer, safer, and drier.
Our crew name was Lemonade Mouth, consisting of advisors Jen Payne and Ken Lewis, along with youth Allie Koch, Callan Vaughn, Evan Reset, and Justin Schwartz. This week we worked on a house for homeowners Doug and Trish and their five cats Gizmo, Smokey, Mimi, Casey, and Mystery. When we arrived at the house, it was in need of new floors in the bedroom and bathroom, as well as structural support for all the floors. In the beginning of the week, the bathroom was completely gutted, and all members of the crew worked together to renovate and improve the house and the lives of Doug and Trish. By the end of the week, we were able to install new plumbing in the bathroom, as well as a toilet, a bathtub, and brand new vinyl flooring. Finally, as much fun as we had working and spending time with Doug and Trish, our crew always made sure to break together and have lunch. Some days, we were even lucky enough to go out on town and get ice cream and milkshakes. This week was so much fun, and we are all extremely lucky for everything we learned and experienced. We are so grateful for everything we had this week.
Hi, I'm Will, and this was my first year participating in FoA. Our crew name was Xenon, and our advisors were Laura, Meg, and Joe. The other kids in our crew were Allie and Lauren. Our homeowner Sandy and her cat Caillou were dealing with many problems in her two-bedroom trailer. A leaking roof and a broken AC unit showed us how powerful water damage can be. Going into the week, we thought we were going to be laying vinyl flooring, but when we removed the subfloor, we discovered other serious problems in the floors and walls.
The AC unit caused serious rot to the foundation of her home. Our main project became removing and replacing the band joist, which holds up the walls. We also had to scab the rotten common joist before installing the new insulation and subfloor. Thanks to extra fundraising, we were able to buy Sandy a new air conditioner, which gave her the ability to use the rest of her home in the hot Tennessee summer. This week was challenging, but by coming together, remaining positive, and working hard, our crew was able to provide Sandy with a sturdy, safe, and sound structure.
Our crew name was The Color of Friendship and was led by advisors Joni and Rob. The youth consisted of Gabby, Seth, Lauren, and Caitlin. Our homeowner was Liz, a friendly elderly woman who lived by herself. The second we met her, it was obvious we were going to love her. Her home was in need of repairs from water damage that Liz couldn't address by herself.
In the beginning of the week, we thought we were going to finish the flooring in her hallway and repair her back stairs. Instead, we pulled up the carpet in her living room and realized there was much more damage than we had expected. So we replaced the band joists, which support the house, and redid the insulation, subfloor, and vinyl in the living room. Throughout the week, even though we faced many hardships, Liz was always there to put a smile on our faces by telling us stories and making fun of us.
It was a daily routine to hit our heads on the lamp dangling in the living room, which always made us laugh. More of our favorite memories included Rob falling down the stairs on day one, and Seth responding to Rob's calls with,
"What did I do now?" Liz would show us her record collection and told us how she loved the disco days and dancing. Even though we had a great time as a crew, saying goodbye to Liz was the hardest part. These experiences have changed us for the better, bringing us all closer together.
Our crew name was Jump In. Our advisors consisted of John Dosky and Allie Lewis, and our youth members were Jake McFarlane, Alex Baratta, Wynn Haslam, and Jess Salgado. Our homeowner's name was Paul, and though he wasn't home most of the week, his dog Bentley kept us entertained by playfully stealing our gloves and begging for our sandwiches.
Because Paul's house was built in the 1800s, our crew needed to help with a few different projects. While some of us repaired the deck, the rest of us were inside working on the bathroom flooring and replacing the tub with a handicap shower. These improvements could allow Paul's wife to be able to come home from the nursing home she currently lives in.
Paul did help us with work on Friday, though he wouldn't have been able to do the whole job himself. Chosen from a large pool of applicants, he was so grateful that we could help him through ASP, and we as a crew were grateful to be able to serve him in his time of need.
Oh! Thank you.